So taking inspiration from the Welwer Flower Boutique logo, I use simple techniques to design a creative logo in around 5 minutes, and you can do the very same too. As designers, we spend a lot of our time online and dealing with sensitive information and content. Dashlane helps keep that information secure, and it saves you time within your workflow by storing your passwords and your delicate information all in one location. To learn more about Dashlane and how it can help you secure and speed up your workflow, stay tuned to the very end of the video and also grab a 30-day free trial of the premium version. So this logo is pretty neat and it does look very creative, but it's actually fairly simple to make in Adobe Illustrator using the techniques that I'm going to show you today. Now we're firstly going to take the curvature tool and make sure we have just a stroke selected in the color palette located in the bottom left of the screen. Now you can press the caps lock key on your keyboard to have the X icon in use, or you can revert back to the standard curvature icon. It just depends on your personal preference. So all we do here is click and make points, and Illustrator is going to map out a nice curved line for us really, really easily. And we're going to make half of the first shape using this method. Now don't worry if your line is not perfectly smooth, because we can adjust that in the next step in the logo design process. On the tail end of the line here, try and make it so the very end of the line is horizontal and flat, and you're soon going to see why later in the tutorial. But for now, increase the stroke weight and then grab the smooth tool, because we can iron out the line until we're happy with the smoothness and the curvature. So finally, for this part of the logo process, press A for the direct selection tool, and then click this anchor point here, and then click and drag the handle out while holding down shift. This will ensure that the very end of the line is horizontal and flat. Now you can move this shape off to one side for now, and then press L for the ellipse tool. Hold down shift and click and drag to make a circle. So we're then going to use a direct selection tool one more time, and click and drag the top anchor point upwards while holding down shift to make sure it remains central. Now you're going to want to make a kind of leaf shape that will fit into the design later. So okay, great, we can now go ahead and finish this section of the logo design. You will need to have the rulers open, so press Command or Control R if you haven't done that already. Then actually right click the rulers and make sure they are set to pixels. And then in the View drop down menu, click the Snap to Pixel option. We're going to be using this setting only briefly in this logo process. So select the first shape and then hold down the Alt Option key and click and drag to make a duplication. You're going to need to reflect the duplication in the transform window, and then carefully bring it together with the original shape, so they're touching at the anchor points exactly. Now this is why we needed to make the line horizontal in the end, so it would connect in a neat manner at the very tip. Now you can select both shapes and then press Command or Control J to join them together. Now bring the first shape in position like so, and then use the align function to make sure the leaf shape is centered properly. Now you can also use the eyedropper tool, which is I on your keyboard, and this will sample the same stroke weight and the same color of the line shape. And speaking of that line shape, we can now round off the ends in the stroke window, which I feel looks best for this design. The next step is optional, but if you outline the stroke, you're not going to be able to adjust the stroke weight from here onwards, and it's also going to change the final outcome later, as you will see. But it's up to you if you want to outline this shape or not. So we use the snap to pixel function to perform the next step, and that is to drag two guides that touch the edges of our design perfectly, and do this the exact same on both sides. Then move one guide a set amount of pixels, so for me that's going to be 10 pixels. And then go ahead and move the other side the exact same number of pixels. Now this is crucial and it needs to be absolutely perfect. So once you've done that, hold down the Alt Option key to duplicate the leaf shape over to here. Now we do need to turn off the Snap to Pixel option so we can align the leaf exactly centered along this guide. Once you have it in place, press C for the scissors tool, and then cut the top and the bottom of the leaf like so. And then you can use the selection tool to click the sections we don't want and then hit delete to remove them. And we're very close to the end of this creative logo design process, so again use the Alt Option key to duplicate this half leaf. And you can use the magenta smart guides to keep things in line, or you can just hold down Shift as you move it across. Now once it's been duplicated, mirror the shape with the reflect function, and then place it exactly up against the guide, level with the other side. So now the final step of the process, open up the brushes window and select your entire design. Go ahead and create a new brush in the fly down menu, and we're going to be using a pattern brush for this design. The default options should be okay if you've actually aligned everything perfectly. So now you've just made a new brush, we can apply that brush to a circle with a stroke only. So use the ellipse tool on your keyboard being L. And then simply click the brush whilst you have the circle activated. Now you can change the stroke weights, and if you did outline the stroke earlier, the inner sections here of the design might be uneven in thickness, like you can see. So that's the method for creating this creative logo design with my easy technique step by step. We didn't spend much time on the design itself. Another way to save time as a graphic designer is Dashlane, who are sponsoring today's video. A Dashlane is an application that can save your passwords and your vital information in one secure location, as well as saving you time in your design workflow, so you don't have to keep resetting your passwords every time you forget them. You can download the Dashlane app on one device for a lifetime totally for free, and then secure everything with one master password. The neat thing is that Dashlane doesn't actually store your master password, so even if there is a hack, the encryption will prevent your data from being compromised. Now another cool feature that will save you time in your workflow is the autofill function when filling out forms online. Now you can probably relate to my distaste for these forms because I encounter them pretty much daily, and this tends to eat into my time as a graphic designer over the course of days and weeks. Dashlane can autofill these forms with your information in an instant, which means I have more time to focus on my business and my clientele work. There are other cool features of Dashlane, such as alerting you to when there is someone trying to hack your accounts, a password manager that tells you the health of your passwords, a VPN service to remain anonymous online, and so much more. And you can download the free version of the Dashlane app to one device for life, but the premium version can be downloaded to unlimited devices for a lifetime. Using my link, you're going to have access to the premium version of Dashlane for 30 days as a trial. So do check out Dashlane link down below and start securing and optimizing your online life and career as a graphic designer today. But yeah, do let me know what you thought of today's logo and also the process step by step. Subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content, and until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.